Do you want me to leave?
Why would I want you to leave?
Oh, it's just that usually when the Leafs lose a particularly embarrassing game, you go like, ah, like even more so than usual, and you get rid of the intro altogether, and it's like, you know, special. The Leafs blew a lead and lost. What's so special about that?
Let's go!
Why not?
The Toronto Maple Leafs!
I guess my brand is a yell and scream. I don't script these.
Are the Leafs all right?
So what you get is from the heart. Welcome to LFR. Leafs lose 6-5 in overtime to the Ottawa Senators. You owe my dog a treat. To the people who regularly watch my videos, hello, welcome back. To the people who are watching me for the first time since the David Ayers video, your sickos go to jail. I had this feeling. Because the Leafs were up 5-1, life was good. Joe Thornton scored a goal, that was pretty cool. Travis Boyd, remember that goal? That was a millennia ago. Pierre Engvall even got in on the action, and Austin Matthews was in too cool to celebrate mode. Who's texting me? I'm upset. I said Austin Matthews is in too cool to celebrate mode. And then something happened. Jim Carrey, no, not the guy who was a goalie who happened to win the Vezina that one time, the actor, the world famous actor, Jim Carrey from Toronto, back when he was doing stand-up, I remember he had this bit about the thin veil of sanity and insanity. And he talked about things like, should I stick my fingers into the fan or leave the room right now? And then John Tavares is like, I could do something cool with the puck or I could give it to the other team. The Leafs, the Toronto Maple Leafs, who had just made it 5-1 off a 5-on-3 power play goal. There's less than 10 seconds to go in the period. They give the puck away. The Ottawa Senators take it the other way, and they score. And then the Wall Street Bets forum on Reddit went bananas. Angles anxiety to the moon! Because even though it was 5-2, even though the Leafs were up 3 goals heading into the third period, I'm like, why don't I feel good? And my anxiety said, that's because every Sens goal counts for 2. I said, what? No, they don't. Yep, anxiety boosters, let's go. But they're literally up 3 goals. Nope, it's 5-4. This is irrational. Everyone's mad at you.
Oh no, are they?
Remember that thing you said in grade 7?
I don't know.
Here's everything you said in grade 7.
But none of the, but just remember what we talked about in therapy!
Anyone who's been, say it with me, irrational fears. Do you have a fear?
Yes.
What is it?
That if I go too deep into the lake, I'll be eaten by a shark.
Ah, well, is there any evidence to support the idea that you may be eaten by a shark?
Well, I don't know, there's weird stuff in the water.
You live in Canada, Steve.
Yeah, but global warming.
It's February, Steve! That's an irrational fear. There is no evidence to support the fear, and then when you realize it's irrational, you feel a little bit better. So, the Leafs have a lead in a hockey game, and I have a fear that they will blow it. What is not good for my brain is the mountain of evidence to support the idea that they will blow it!
And Sheldon Keefe said basically the same thing, he just handled it much better.
Sheldon Keefe said... Sheldon Keefe said after the second period that it was as bad as he's ever felt about having a 5-2 lead. Oh! Does any other team have this problem? Seriously, any other self-respecting team, any other Stanley Cup caliber team, have they ever had a 3-goal lead heading into the third and gone, you know what, I don't like the looks of this? The Leafs! It continues, the warning signs were there for the Leafs head coach long before the big Sens comeback. And he's right, there were. I noticed the warning signs too. And if you go back and look at the footage, you'll have to ask TSN for permission, but I'm telling you, trust me on this one. You go back and look at the footage. Right before the third period begins, I see the first warning sign. 20 guys wearing Leafs jerseys take the ice. Listen, credit the Ottawa Senators. They worked their tails off in the third period to secure the tie and in overtime, sacrificing their body to get the win. I didn't know Evgeny Dodonov was just Satan, apparently. Dadinov was right there. But I've even seen some people defending this, like, hey, hey, stuff happens. There were a few bad bounces in there. The theme of this season, if you've been watching these videos, has been you make your own luck. We've talked at length about the number of new things, improved things that this Leafs team has been doing to create situations where they can be lucky.
You cannot blow a 5-1 lead to the league's worst team and call it bad luck!
The Leafs are not defending themselves right now, you shouldn't be either. Speaking of defending themselves, I'm just gonna say it, this team has not looked the same without Wayne Simmons. Please, 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 please don't give any more fuel to the idea that this team needs a babysitter. I'm not even talking about a babysitter who runs around and punches people for you, just a babysitter who can rally the troops with classic hockey bench banter like, hey fellas, what if we didn't blow a 4-1 lead?
Wow, 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 wow. Didn't even mean to do that. I said 4-1.
Fun fact, the Leafs did not blow a 4-1 lead in this game. That was in 2013 against the Boston Bruins, have you heard?
No, 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 no. In this one, they blew a 5-1 lead, which is worse!
Steve, 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 even though it's more goals, it's not worse. That one was in the playoffs!
Sorry, sorry, sorry. Huh? The what?
Oh, the playoffs. I've heard of them. Have they made it legal to win in them yet? What's that?
It's been legal the whole time, they just suck!
I've talked about this many times. Every season, it seems the Leafs have an early season traumatic defensive performance, but it's usually creepily in the first three games.
Arguably, they had one in the second game against Ottawa this season.
Ah, there they are again. Like all good teams in this league, the worst team in the league is giving them fits.
But I'm talking about early season defensive performances that make you feel for the rest of the season like this team is incapable of holding a lead. Like, for example, the home opener a few years ago. It was against the New York Rangers. How did that go? The Leafs were up 5-1 and then blew it!
Yeah, they won 8-5. Kinda wish they didn't.
But it was like globbing a bunch of icing onto a mountain of boogers.
And that's the thing about wins like that and the regular season, because the first few bites taste like cake.
But every year, right on time, usually at the hands of the Boston Bruins, but last year they decided to spice it up and made it against Columbus, they discover it's snot!
Steve, I really didn't need that visual.
Me neither, but I watched it for 3 hours anyway.
Wait, what are you talking about?
Dude, just when we started talking about this team, like, hey, they're different.
No.
No, okay, whoa. I like you freaking out and everything, but one game, granted a bad one, does not make this team that's in first place bad.
Oh, my sweet summer child. Such innocence, so pure, I wish I could bottle it.
No, one regular season loss on a Monday in February doesn't make you bad.
But finishing first place in the regular season doesn't make you a Stanley Cup champion.
You can talk about Freddie not being able to come up with the big save. You can talk about John Tavares and the big giveaway. You can talk about Morgan Riley looking off Austin Matthews in overtime.
At the end of the day, every player on this team had a slice of cake.
And oh, it's Christmas for the rest of hockey Twitter. Do you want to see everyone dunking on him?
Here's some of my favorite tweets so far. This is going to last for months.
I like this one. I like hard-hitting analysis. He's right there!
For as mad as you can be at Morgan Riley, who was looking off Austin Matthews for the hat-trick goal and the game winner right there, they had still blown a 4-goal lead at this point.
Blew 5-1 lead to the Senators.
That one's funny.
Dadonov is the new Bergeron, I guess.
Twitch.
How it started versus how it's going. Haha.
Say what you will about the Leafs, but this is going to be a great segment on that Amazon show.
I deeply hate how correct that is.
And my personal favorite, are we really going to get this mad about our number two goalie costing us a win? Jack Campbell's still a week away.
Here's how I'd like to end things. Yes, I'd like to go right back to boogers.
I've talked about the booger cake, a mound of boogers that is covered in icing and the Leafs eat it throughout the regular season and don't discover it's a mound of boogers until the playoffs.
By blowing a 5-1 lead to the Senators and losing in overtime, you unhinged your jaw like an anaconda and swallowed the thing whole. You know! You discovered it now, congrats! And the fact that the coach had an ominous feeling with a 3-goal lead, a 5-2 lead heading into the third period, 20 minutes to play against the league's worst team, what's wrong? The fans are so mean to this team.
The best thing I can say about that game is there were no fans who paid to be in the building.
And the fans, the Leafs do this every year and we're still here.
Because think of how great it's gonna be when Charlie Brown finally kicks that football. Oh. It's gonna be great. This year. Maybe.
So now you got a blessing. You got an opportunity. You get 2 more games against the Ottawa Senators coming up. What are you gonna do? You gonna make them pay for it? Hellfire and fury? Show them what you're made of?
Just focus on beating them first.
So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. I made a video like an hour before this one talking about the Alex Galchenyuk trade. And listen to the most recent Steve Dangle podcast on the Steve Dangle Podcast YouTube channel and wherever else the podcast is, Spotify, etc. Because we had the Rated R Superstar Edge on it. We talked about the Leafs. We had so much hope. Ah.